Ram raids have been dominating the headlines. The latest, an Auckland jewellery store where thieves carried out a brazen daylight robbery.
But the tables were turned when locals and neighbouring shop owners fought back.
The moment a community swung into action. You can hear the glass smashing as thieves invade Ellerslie Jewellers and Engravers across the street.
Yeah, I got the photo.
The response was quick. Loyal locals trying their best to stop them in their tracks. Initially, they got away, only to be caught by police later in the day. And now the cleanup begins. So how's the jeweller coping with this daunting aftermath? And John Rennell from Ellerslie Jewellers is here now. Thanks so much for your time, John. Watching that footage, that must have been pretty terrifying for everyone in store. How are your staff feeling after what happened?
Well, Jeremy and Hillary, they're obviously traumatised. They feel very, very emotional. But I know they're vulnerable, but we are all very stoic and they've coped very well. The best thing was nobody was injured.
And we also saw from the video that plenty of the public tried to help. I mean, how does that make you feel about your community?
I'm very proud, humble. It's quite incredible the way they all rallied and tried to defend us. It's just an amazing community here in Ellerslie. And it was shown by that. I mean, we had the community patrol came out and guarded the front. We had two off-duty policemen that chipped in and helped guard the front. One of them chased on the bike to track the car. One other one came out of a restaurant opposite and slashed two of the tires. And so the car couldn't get away for any speed at all. And then my dear neighbour next door, the mother and the daughter, they were so brave, they went out and tried to tackle one of the getaways, and the daughter had her hand in the door trying to stop them getting away, and she's badly bruised.
And John, with an incident like this, how long before you can get back into business?
Oh, Jeremy, it'll be 3, maybe 4 weeks. All of the glass on our cabinets have been broken and destroyed. They were hit with, I think, probably hammers. Then they walked across the mall, they buckled and broke everything. And it's gut-wrenching to watch it on our security cameras as they steal everything.
That must be such a blow, particularly in the lead-up to Christmas.
It is, sadly, Hillary. I mean, it's our peak time. We build the stock up to be able to try and reap the benefits of this. And sadly, these five villains have got away with a lot of it.
And John, jewellery stores appear to be targeted more than ever at the moment. How are police helping?
They are fantastic. Look at yesterday. It was probably within half an hour they had the five. And I don't know how much stock they've managed to recover. That will be several days before I'm aware of it. But they really are. Their hands are tied behind their back. They're under-resourced. And I think they're doing a brilliant job. My complaint really is against the government. Hipkins, we've been in correspondence with him now for about 3 or 4 months, talking about this risk that we all are as small businesses. I'm not just talking about myself, I'm an advocate for them all small businesses. We need the help. Where's the $6 million fund that they announced in May? There's been 5 or 7 fog cannons installed since then.
So specifically, is there anything else that the government could do other than the fog cannons to help small business owners like yourself right now?
Hillary, a few years ago, in their budget cuts, they took away our community constable. And ever since then, crime in our village has progressively got worse. So that's one thing that they could do. I know they're short of people, but why not go back to that good old Bobby on the beat, and that keeps away the criminals?
What do you think other business people can do to protect not just their stores at the moment, but also their staff?
Well, I guess the safest thing you can do is have a protocol in place. We certainly did have. We have rehearsed what we would do in the event of what happened yesterday. I'm pleased to say that my family and staff did exactly as they were trained, and there was no effort, no result. I'm sorry.
It's okay. I can only imagine how hard I'm crying too, because I feel for you so much. It's heart-wrenching. You know, you build up a business.
It is.
For years and years and years, and I know this has been your your life.
For my family.
Yeah, it's a
Never mind.
I mean, it's
I'll try and recover.
No, it is a terrifying thing that you've gone through, John. It really is.
It is. Yeah. Well, the thing is, it's not just me, Hillary. It's just going on all the time. I mean, it's and the poor police, what can they do? What can they do? I don't know the answers, but by God, they've got to research it and do something.
All the best, John. It is lovely to talk to you. And look, we hope that you're back in business sooner rather than later.
Thank you, Hillary. Thank you, Jeremy. I just want to compliment our village again. Our people are unbelievably loyal. And if you think about all that they did yesterday and the bravery that they showed, it's humble. Thank you.